dead or something.
Yeah, really. I don't get that.
So, I mean, or, you know, I got to follow my fantasy football. So, I mean, we have all these, which aren't necessarily bad, but still have the potential to become an idol. And so, we have all those today, so it's very easy to not understand, you know, the time and effort these men put in to keep God's word in the language of the people and to distribute it also. Of course, you know, that came to a halt in Martin Luther's, or prior to Martin Luther's time. And so, and you know, once he got the ball rolling with that, look what happened.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, that's, I would say that's one of my favorite times in history. I could discuss that all night. Be happy.
Yeah. Well, he said that he didn't post much things, but when he did, things happened.
Yeah. Exactly. Yeah. My father participated in a really neat documentary about that. The men who put the DVD together were friends of my father, and they actually went to Germany and interviewed people. And they still hold in spite of the problems in Germany, I mean, they still hold a festival honoring the day Martin Luther put up the 95 Theses. Kind of put on a little like carnival and things like that of how it was back then. And it was really neat, and they all Todd Friel from Wretched is also on this video.
Yeah, and he's always causing stuff.
He's funny.
Yeah, he is.
That's kind of, and I think I like Todd Friel. My dad, you know, alluded to, you know, the strength of people like Martin Luther, who really had the willpower to keep going. And my dad said, you know, sometimes people like that may not be always the most pleasant people to meet.
Right.
But in a way, it really kind of takes that type of boldness to get something going, like the Reformation. And my dad alluded to his friend Ian Paisley.
Oh yeah.
My dad, he knew Paisley. I think he met one, I don't know, 17, 18 years of age. He met Ian Paisley. Ian Paisley was about probably 6 or 7 years older than my dad, and really played a big part in my dad's kind of growing up in faith, and he trained my dad in some areas. And then my dad ended up coming to America and doing some studying. But it's interesting because Ian Paisley is so famous that Liam Neeson actually played in some movie. I don't remember the name of the movie. And Liam Neeson confessed that he actually sat in some services to observe Paisley and his preaching. And I don't think he's saved, but he did say that his preaching did actually, you know, have some sort of impact on him.
And, okay.
You know, Neeson was, he was a devout Roman Catholic growing up. I don't know what he is now. But it's interesting, though, that the impact Paisley had on Northern Ireland. And I think politically, too, Paisley didn't run for office. I don't know what Northern Ireland would have turned into. Because it was when the IRA started to reform and start doing their demonstrations, like, it was really getting bad in Northern Ireland. really divisive, and to the point where, you know, the Protestant side finally just, you know, they raised up, you know, the Ulster Volunteer Force and all that, all these kind of paramilitary groups started to come to the fore. And, yeah, I mean, I don't know what would have happened if somebody, you know, didn't sound the alarm, you know, on the problems there. But I mean, our press, you know, our media over here, just they basically out to be a monster. And really, he was like kind of like Trump today. I mean, really just an answer to all of the
John Knox and Trump and Paisley. That would be a good trio.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Yeah, my dad, he can't vote, he's still a British citizen, but he was watching some of the things happening there, and you know, what Trump would always have these paid protesters come and try to disrupt them. And my dad said that's just like Ian Paisley, you know, when he first started to run for British Parliament. Really, I kind of see Antifa kind of the same way, like the IRA. They kind of started out peaceful and just...
There's not a peaceful bone in their body.
No. Well, they wanted to appear that way, but
They say they are, but they're not.
Yeah, they started to... Yeah. That's exactly what the IRA did, and they went and, you know, really got militant and started to basically form.
Have you seen Patriot Games?
Yes.
Yeah.
Well, and funny how true that, because that's really what happened. The IRA ended up disbanding, I mean, well, dividing anyways. The IRA, as we know it, has become more involved trying to do things on a more political level, and then the zealots form the real IRA, which is really still wreaking a lot of havoc in Great Britain, and even Roman Catholics are scared because they're, it's not just political anymore, they're into like drug trafficking now.
Yeah.
So
they're more of a gang than a political.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Okay. Yep. See, I enjoyed the discussion, but I think I better stop. It's about 5 o'clock now. And, I enjoyed this discussion, but I better